Hello everyone, myself Advocate Gautam Arswal, associate with Dialysi. Welcome to Dialysi. Today in this video, I'm going to discuss with you recently Madhya Pradesh High Court's decision in which Madhya Pradesh High Court basically quashes rape case. What happened in this case? Let's find out in this video. So starting with the very beginning, the court said that over one year enough time for women to realize whether promise to marry was genuine or false. There has been several fake cases which been filed against boys in India or males by their woman partner on the name of fake marriage promises. The Madhya Pradesh High Court recently held that over a one year's time is sufficient for a prudent woman to realize whether a promise made by a man to marry her was a false promise from its very inception or whether it was merely a breach of genuine promise. The name of the case is Amar Singh Rajput versus State and another. Justice Deepak Kumar Agarwal relied on a number of Supreme Court judgments to highlight that there is a clear distinction between mere breach of a promise and giving a false promise to marry. A breach of a genuine promise to marry is not punishable under law. Only a false promise to marry made with an intention to deceive a woman would vitiate the woman's consent, the court explained in this case. On the other hand, a mere breach of promise cannot be said to be a false promise, the court noted in this case. The observations were made while quashing a rape case filed against a man for allegedly having sexual relations with a woman on a false promise to marry her. In this case, the court found that the complainant had been in a relationship with the accused for a long time and that she had herself gone to the residence of the accused. The court in this case also said that more than one year time is sufficient time for a prudent woman to realize as to whether the promise is a promise of marriage made by the petitioner false from its very inception or there is a possibility of breach of promise. The court also questioned why the complainant had continued the relationship when the accused had not accepted to her requests for marriage. So I hope you're pretty much clear with the facts of this case. These are the brief facts of the case. In case of any, you want me to discuss detailed discussion, do let me know in the comment section. See you on the next video with some more information.